we see that the chief guest and the other guests of honors have arrived. There's going to be a small puja. In fact, the chief guest is being welcomed with the Purna Kumbham. That's the tradition of Telangana, where you actually welcome the chief guest coming to your home or to any of these occasions with a Purna Kumbham. So that's the formal inauguration of the Public Safety Integrated Operations Center. Developed in partnership with L&T Smart World, this center will help in real-time surveillance through the CCTV cameras that are installed under the limits of Hyderabad, Cyberabad and Rajakonda Police Commissionerates. This apart, the cameras installed elsewhere in the state can also be linked to this center. The intelligence thus gathered is proactively provided to the field officers to help in the investigation process. The dignitaries are performing puja to mark the auspicious beginning. The Telangana government announced the Integrated Police Command Control Center, which is actually coming up in Banjara Hills, for better monitoring of law and order and to make the state a safe place in all aspects of the overall development. This control center will have four towers, a data center and a command control center with a total built-up area of around 6.2 lakh square feet. It will deliver public police services of global standards and would be connected with over 1 lakh CCTVs, traffic management technologies, crime control process, and will also act as a one-stop hub for incident management system. It would also act as a multi-agency operation center for quick contact with departments like the fire department, disaster management, revenue, GHMC, R&B, health and others. In an effort to develop better community policing, improved communications and reduce the crime in Telangana, the police has made every police station a command center and the incident management is managed here at the command centers. So far, 104 command centers have been set up by the police in the police stations with video functionalities to map the real-time incidents. This center is the first of its kind. It's an integrated operation center and will integrate all these command centers at the police stations to give intelligence proactively to to the field officers and also help in making sure that the required data and intelligence is coordinated with the agencies, thus cutting down the time taken for the investigation. After the puja, the dignitaries will proceed to unveil the inauguration plaque, and this center is distributed on two floors. The ground floor is the operation center with the video walls that you actually see, which is meant for the real-time monitoring. And there is the emergency response systems for Dial 100 and Hawkeye app that would be set up soon here. Post this inauguration, the dignitaries would be proceeding to the first floor for the inauguration of the plaque there. The first floor has a war room, which you actually can see there, and the data center. This data center has been enabled with video-centric storage systems. Ladies and gentlemen, I think one round of huge applause, because this is the first of its kind, not just in India, but in the world itself, where multiple agencies would be integrated. Ladies and gentlemen, the dignitaries are now in the war room. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the chief guest, the visionary himself, Sri K.T. Rama Rao Garu, the Honorable Minister for IT, E&C, Municipal Administration, Urban Development and Industries, Government of Telangana. Joining him are Sri Mohammed Mehmood Ali, Honorable Minister for Home, Prisons and Fire Services, Government of Telangana, Srimati P. Sabita Indra Reddy, Honorable Minister for Education, Government of Telangana, Sri Arakapudi Gandhi, Government Whip and MLA, Serilingampally Constituency, Dr. Buntu Ram Mohan, Mayor, GHMC, Sri K. Naveen Kumar, MLC, Sri Koleti Damodar, Chairman, TSPHC, Sri M. Mahendra Reddy Garu, IPS, Director General of Police, Telangana State, Sri Anjani Kumar, IPS, Commissioner of Police, Hyderabad City, Sri Ravi Gupta, IPS, Principal Secretary to Government, Home Department, Telangana State, Sri Jayesh Ranjan, IAS, Principal Secretary, Department of IT, Government of Telangana, Sri Mahesh Bhagwat Garu, IPS, Commissioner of Police, Rajakonda, Sri VC Sajnar, IPS, Commissioner of Police, Cyberabad, and the other dignitaries, along with the executives from the L&T Smart World Organization. May I request the dignitaries to kindly be seated. Since the emergence of the Telangana state, the Telangana government took up many projects to enhance Hyderabad city's position as a growth propeller. It's the Honorable CM, Sri KCR Garu's vision to make Hyderabad the best city with smart governance, smart living, smart mobility, smart environment and smart economy. And it is with this vision the government set about creating people-friendly police and modernizing the police department by digitizing its operations using cutting-edge technology. Telangana State Police Department is committed to deliver the most efficient, effective, productive and quality service to the community, and the fructification of this commitment is the Public Safety Integrated Operations Center. May I now invite Sri Mahendra Reddy Garu, IPS, DGP of Telangana State to address the gathering.
Sabak Namaskaram. At the very outset, I welcome all the dignitaries, the distinguished invitees, all the senior officers of the Government of Telangana. It's a proud privilege for us that today we have with us Sri K.T. Ramarao Garu, Honorable Minister for IT, Municipal Administration and Urban Development, Industries, Government of Telangana, Sri Mahmood Ali Garu, Honorable Minister for Home, Prisons and Fire Services, Government of Telangana, Srimati Savita Indra Reddy Garu, Honorable Minister for Education, Government of Telangana, Sri Arikapudi Gandhi, Government Whip, Member of Legislative Assembly, Sherlingampally Assembly Constituency, Sri Dr. Bantu Ramohan, Mayor, GHMC, Sri K. Naveen Kumar, Member of Legislative Council, Sri Koleti Damodar Garu, Chairman, Telangana State Police Housing Corporation, the distinguished CEOs, the entrepreneurs, the senior officials of the government departments from all wings of Telangana government, the technical personnel of L&T representing the Integrated Operations Center here, members of the media, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen. I feel it as a proud privilege to stand before you on this august occasion. It's a dream coming true for Telangana. In 2014, when the state of Telangana was formed, the Honorable Chief Minister gave us a vision. Come what may, we must have the best law and order in the country in Telangana state. We must have the best sense of safety and security among the people in the entire Telangana state, and more so especially in Hyderabad city. The government and the Honorable Chief Minister truly believe public safety and maintenance of law and order is an essential prerequisite for development, for welfare and well-being of the society. If the state has to progress, if we have to attract investments globally, if we have to ensure that the wealth is created and then the fruits of wealth are distributed to the poor and the downtrodden in the entire state of Telangana, the essential prerequisite is maintenance of public order and peace, and ensuring that every individual within our society feels safe, secure, to live in Hyderabad, to visit Hyderabad, to conduct business in Hyderabad, and to travel in Hyderabad, to Hyderabad and state of Telangana. So therefore, the vision of Honorable Chief Minister and Government of Telangana, as a part of translation of this vision, we have come up with this Telangana State Police Public Safety Integrated Operations Center, supported by a Tier 3 data center. As you all know, in the last 6 years, we have come a long way in ensuring that the standards of safety and security in Telangana, and more specifically in Hyderabad city, have been upgraded when compared to any other city or the state in the country. We always believed as a government, as a department, that technology should be used as a force multiplier. As always it is said, one CCTV camera is equivalent to 100 police personnel. A camera which never lies, a camera which gives transparency, a camera which gives a certainty of being caught and certainty of being punished. So therefore, to leverage this technology, the government of Telangana and police department have come up with this today's facility that's just now launched by our Honorable Minister for IT, Industries and Municipal Administration. Sir, we are very fortunate to have you here. You being from the technology background, you appreciate what we are doing in Telangana Police. Whether it be women safety, whether it is a cyber security, whether it be the general law and order, or whether it is a common man's requirement of grievance redressal, Telangana Police has been in the forefront in applying the latest technologies in all fields of police work. The fruits of technology must reach the common man. The day the common man feels that the service delivery at the cutting edge level has improved and he is in a position to access the police services on 24/7 without anybody's support, and if he has that reassurance that if there is a difficulty, if there is an emergency, police always is available and they would help me irrespective of whether I know someone in the department or we do not know. So therefore, the emergency response management system, today this facility would be housing the Dial 100 center. It would be 24/7, and this facility also has all the modern technologies brought together as a technology fusion center. So we are also fortunate that the Honorable Home Minister today we have with us, who has been a great support in taking forward all these initiatives and giving a pat on our back every moment that we do something good. He has always been there in the forefront to encourage us and take us forward. I would also like to invite and thank Honorable Minister for Education, Savita Indira Reddy Garu, who has been a great support when this police commissionerate was formed in 2002. I was the first police commissioner to join here, and in the process of development of this entire infrastructure for the Hyderabad Police Commissionerate, Madam has given, as the Home Minister at that time, outstanding support. And today, if Hyderabad Police is able to deliver the services at the level that it is doing, her contribution also is there in the entire effort. I also welcome all other distinguished guests for being with us. We are very happy and we feel it as a privilege. I also welcome all the CEOs who have taken time of various companies, both IT, infrastructure, service sector, all wings of the industry. They have been made part of the Hyderabad Security Council today, and we have been able to bring synergy so that it is not only the IT and ITES industries, but manufacturing industries, service sector industries, all of them should flourish. All of them need to have a sense of safety and security. And if they know on a daily basis what we are doing for ensuring the safety of the communities living here, working here, producing goods and services and wealth for the society, I welcome you all, the executives, for this meeting. And similarly, this facility would not have come forward without the support of all the government departments. We have the senior officers from various government departments, including MAUD, the transport, R&B, the GHMC, like this various departments who have a role either directly or indirectly in ensuring the public safety and security and smooth flow of the traffic. We have all of them here and who are going to be partners in this entire effort, because this is going to act as a multi-agency operation center where the representatives of all the government departments will be here. The technology, through technology, whatever intelligence we are going to produce here, it's going to be used by all the line departments so that their own service delivery at the cutting edge level is improved by multiple times. So I welcome you all. I also welcome all my esteemed colleagues from the police department who have been a backbone for the government, and also to the department who have been part of this entire effort in bringing this facility up today. Sir, the Hyderabad Safe and Smart City project was conceived with an objective for citizen-friendly, holistic, integrated and responsive CCTV-based surveillance system for the cities of Hyderabad, Cyberabad and Ratchakonda, and to transform the traffic management system from today's technology into a safer, more efficient and a demonstrable system for the future. The project is in alignment with the vision of Telangana government and Telangana police to create safe and secure communities through planned and accountable policing, to provide reassurance and responsive police services, to effectively prevent and control organized crimes, to improve road safety, handling accidents, disasters and crisis management, to improve overall the quality of life of every citizen living here and ensure safer living conditions for them. The nerve center of this project is the Telangana Police Public Safety Integrated Operations Center, which is launched today, which hosts the Integration Operation Command, computer-aided dispatch, call taking and call dispatching, and the state-of-the-art data center. Telangana Police Public Safety Integrated Operations Center provides a single view of 15,000 government cameras at one time, government and community CCTV cameras, and it brings in the feed at one time 1 lakh cameras from all over the city, and then we will be able to view on the screen 15,000 cameras simultaneously at one time. And it has 126 geographically distributed command centers which are located in the respective police stations, so that each police station can have a similar command center set up in their own police station and then do the policing on 24/7, more nearer to the field activities. That would empower the police officers at the cutting edge level. They would take more interest, get ingrained into the technologies and use the technology for the benefit of the community. Sir, similarly, this IOC is also capable of integrated traffic management through sensor-based traffic counting and classification and AI-based enforcement and automatic challenging systems. So the Telangana State Public Safety IOC leverages cutting-edge technologies like big data analytics, data landscape, computer vision, facial recognition, IoT integration, data correlation, machine learning, geospatial analytics, cyber security, and so on and so forth. The name a technology that is available in the market, today we have used it in a small way or a big way, but our vision is to absorb all the developing technologies as the time goes so that we are always ahead of the offenders. As you know, the offenders are the first to use the technologies and then commit crime. If you see the cyber crimes today, all over the world, people are coming into the cyberspace and then making the, you know, local populations, people of Telangana, people of Hyderabad, people of various states, they are becoming the victims. Therefore, if we have to counter the efforts of these cyber offenders and other offenders who are using the latest technologies, police has to be ahead of all other stakeholders, so that we are in a position to neutralize their efforts and prevent crime. Therefore, the efficacy of the police department is in our ability to prevent, rather than dealing and allowing a crime to happen and then dealing with it. Therefore, we give a lot of importance to the crime prevention, so that the people at large feel safe, secure, and always they know that the police is available and they will be able to reach within no time the moment they call the police. Today, our response time in Hyderabad city is 5 minutes, less than 5 minutes. So any time, any individual, whether rich or poor, whether educated or uneducated, if they are able to do the dial 100, whether it is child, whether it is male, female, irrespective of the status of the individual, the police reaches them and ensure that they are taken care. That's the reliable, that's a validated service that we would like to give on a regular basis, so that the people have that sense of safety and security, irrespective of whether their relatives are standby, whether the known people are there, not there. Every individual, the state is in a position to protect them and give them that sense of safety and security. So therefore, I finally conclude saying that this Telangana Police Public Safety Integrated Operation Center benefits the law enforcement officials, all other government departments and the society at large through preventive policing, unified incident response, quicker investigation turnaround, and integrated traffic management and automated violation enforcement. In addition to this, to just give you one view of what the command center can do, oka neram jarigithe police station nunchi investigation officer crime scene ku velle loplo aa neram evaru chesaru gathamlo alanti neralu chesina vallu evaru vaalla locations ekkada unnai ee neram most probably evaru chestuntaru anedi mana io crime scene ku vellaka munde tanaku manam intelligence ku develop chesi ivvadam dwara we will be empowering all the investigation officers. Alage patrols area lo unnappudu tanu oka area lo oka colony lo enter aithe aa colony lo gathamlo em em neralu jarigayi evarevaru offenders akkada nivasistunnaru ikkada possibility of neralu malla jarige avakasam em undi anedi manam ai dwara analytics dwara danni analyze chesi prati patrol officer kuda every moment tanu unnatvanti area lo aa awareness ivvadam dwara tanni manam we will be involving them more and more in the work, and then they will be more and more committed to the crime prevention and taking timely actions in the interest of the safety and security. Itlage manam ee system lo the unique system for the facility today what we have managed is there are disparate systems ante dial 100 system undi ts cop an cheppese all apps integrated app undi hawkeye an cheppese public systems nunchi vachedundi aa public interface nunchi atlage social media channels ఇట్లా రకరకాల బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్స్ నుంచి ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ని ఒకేసారి దాన్ని అనలైజ్ చేసి ఒక ఇంటిగ్రేటెడ్ వ్యూ ఇవ్వడం అనేది దిస్ ఇస్ ది మోస్ట్ సిగ్నిఫికెంట్ ఆస్పెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఫెసిలిటీ. వీ హ్యావ్ ఎ స్మాల్ ప్రెజెంటేషన్ ఆన్ దట్ అండ్ విత్ దిస్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు వన్స్ అగైన్ వెల్కమ్ ఆల్ ద డిగ్నిటరీస్ అండ్ వీ ఫీల్ ప్రౌడ్ అండ్ ఆనర్డ్ బై యువర్ ప్రెజెన్స్ టుడే. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఆల్.
Thank you, sir. Telangana state ranks among the safest states and Hyderabad one of the safest cities in India. Truly living up to the motto of the Telangana Police, with you and for you always. Thanks so much for all the efforts. The Public Safety Integrated Operation Center at Cyberbar is the first of its kind, as I said, not just in the country but in the world. It deploys AI, machine learning technologies, and so many other technologies that Mahinder Reddy Garu has actually outlined. And these will generate automatic alerts, thus help in the real-time surveillance of the city. The usage of AI is in line with the vision of Honorable CM Garu, who has declared 2020 as the year of AI and make Hyderabad among the top 25 global AI innovation hubs. May I invite Mr. JVS Ramakrishna Garu from L&T Smart World to share more details about the center. JVS heads the strategy and solutions at Smart World, an organization that is working with several agencies in India focusing on smart and safe cities and communication. Over to you, JVS.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning, sir. And thank you very much for this opportunity. I am not sure if I can match up DGP Garu's passion and vision, but let me do the justice with what I can do. We have started this project with inline to the Telangana State Police vision that is put in place to actually So before I start off this vision, sir, actually it's my truly a privilege to actually be part of this initiative. When we started off, we have actually taken a typical surveillance view and traffic management view, which we do most of the cities because we engage with quite a few government agencies. But thanks to DGP Garu, what we had to take from day one is a system view, how actually it can help at the cutting edge to the field officer, who is the judge in terms of the policing, and the citizen who ultimately is going to be delighted. So when we had to change this whole system, we actually have benchmarked with New York, Los Angeles, we've been talking to the Chicago police and all, what are the best practices available in the world. But while we have taken the best practices, the best of the technology available, what we also have realized is we need to do good amount of work to solve our local problems. That's where actually an integrated system was envisaged, number one. And number two is, today I can tell you that I stand in front of you that this is one of the best systems implemented in the area of public safety. When we talk to the global providers, I mean, could it be any city, people are actually looking at us awe. Of course, the proof is in pudding in terms of improving on the ground in terms of using the system. So we'll be working towards that, sir. With that, with your permission, I'll start off the presentation. Sir, as DGP Garu actually was mentioning, Telangana police has actually have got put in few objectives in terms of the police. One is to effectively prevent and control organized crimes and to provide reassurance on responsive police services. Sir, we are here, we are not talking about general policing, we call as police services at the end of the day. To improve the road safety, handling accidents, disasters and crisis management. To create safe and secure communities through planned and accountable policing. Sir, here the key word is accountable policing. So some of these systems will bring in that accountability right up to the constable to the topmost layer from the policing point of view. And at the same time, with all these things, the idea is to actually to improve the quality of life. Probably this is the only policing force which we have seen, which actually have defined citizen as the core stakeholder and defined quality of service and ensuring safe living conditions as one of the vision. Sir, in line to this vision, when this project Hyderabad Safe and Smart City was envisaged, initially it was called CCTV and traffic management, but subsequently it was rechristened to be Safe and Smart City. The reason for that is we wanted to implement a citizen-friendly, holistic, most importantly integrated. Sir, in our systems, what is happening is we have an incident management, we have some investigation officers, we have got various functions, but there is a lot of data actually sitting in, information sitting in multiple places, which actually takes time to really stitch all these things to actually attend any particular problem within the realm of urban life. So having an integrated system and responsive CCTV based surveillance for all the three commissioners of Hyderabad to transform traffic system from today's technology into more safer and demonstrable system for the future. This was the vision with which we started off around 3 years back, sir. The objectives were safe and provide safe and security, improved responsiveness. The key thing is the field officer empowerment. Unlike the command centers, typically what we do, sir, is that we bring in the information to the central place and we expect the command center to provide information and be hub of the activity. Here what we have done is we have chosen the field officer as the hub of the activity and we are providing all the information to them. So that is the key over here. And of course effective police services and the to be delivered with the citizen delight in the mind. So some of the unique features here, I would like to actually spend a minute of time here. Sir, this is, I'm proudly to say that this is India's first integrated safe city. The reason I didn't put world because there are many bits and pieces happening in the world, but definitely with all confidence I can say this is India's first integrated safe city, benchmark with any city that we are in the world. Why it is so special? Number one, we have one incident and emergency management system, which means that we have one system to get in incidents coming from either dial 100, social media, even the police stations, all coming into one place to have a common operating picture of a particular city. One integrated security platform with collaborative monitoring. This is again an important point I want to mention here, sir. Other than New York and Chicago, most of the cities actually treat the government cameras separately and the community cameras separately. Here we have taken a view of one view in terms of government and community cameras to provide seamless services to the citizens. So that is a very important thing there in the top right corner. The second one is one integrated traffic management. Sir, what we have done here is, it's not about just an enforcement. We have brought in the incident management, traffic actually counting, classification, which will help further the other agencies in terms of roadworks and all, are actually put in wherein we have one view of the traffic management and one multi-agency operations center. This is where actually the DGP Gar was also mentioning, it's not about the normal operations. How do I leverage the existing infrastructure, data and processes which can be leveraged by other departments? For example, it could be GHMC, could be utilities, or could be any other department, wherein we can have synergies between the multiple departments. That one multi-agency operation center is being planned out of Twin Towers. Like DGP Gar was mentioning, we have 126 geographically distributed command centers with a focus on this local police stations. This is something unique. Nowhere, no city has emulated this sort of system. Last one is real-time insights to the field officer. Sir, if you see the whole pitch, what I'm talking about, everywhere we have the field officer at the center, not the senior officer or the command center. So that's the most important thing for us, so that the field officer is empowered enough to react to any situation on the ground. How is this possible? Basically based on three things. One is the Internet of Things, the integration of the sensors on the street seamlessly using robust networks, which I'll talk about briefly, and augmented intelligence. So here it's not only just about artificial intelligence throwing some alerts here and there. We actually have augmented intelligence wherein we actually enhance the intelligence using various sources of data. So the infrastructure for this, if you see here on the field, this is what actually is being put in, sir. One is around 10,000 government cameras, 38 facial recognition cameras, 100,000 community cameras integration, 126 command centers. We are covering effectively 828 junctions across the city, across all the three commissionerates, and we also have around 1300 GPS-enabled connected patrol cars for effective servicing. This is on the CCTV and services. On the traffic side, we are actually doing automatic enforcement in around 150 junctions. We have 25 SOS in public places, 25 mobile VMDs wherein we can actually connect and put in wherever we want to disseminate information to the citizens. 130 junctions we are putting variable display messages, 80 junctions we are having public address systems, and 32 junctions we are doing vehicle counting and classification, which is again state of the art system. No city in India has even implemented this till now, when we will get real time information of data and congestion statistics on selected corridors and junctions. All these things are being serviced by for three commissionerates with one integrated operation center, one multi-agency operation center, with one DC and DR active in both Hyderabad and Twin Towers. This is the overall infrastructure we have, sir. This is the data center, sir, we have seen just now. This is the state of the data center, which is more tuned towards video surveillance storage systems to store this sort of high data intensive, video intensive systems. Sir, I also need to mention you here, we also have a SOC implemented security operations center, because this is a core critical data that is being stored here. Not only the security at the operator's level on the application side, but also the data center has got a SOC for any attacks that can happen in the data center, sir. So this looks a busy slide, but I just wanted to mention here, this is also a very important slide over here. Connecting these sensors on the field to a command center or an integrated operation center is the most critical activity in any of these IoT type of architectures. We actually have tied up, government of Telangana has tied up with Reliance Jio network to provide close to around 70 Gbps of network backbone, sir. This actually connects to the data center in Twin Towers, data center here, what we have seen today inaugurated, multi-agency tower at Twin Towers, this particular operations center and all the field infrastructure, that is police stations and field. Sir, actually Reliance Jio is actually helping us to provide almost a 70 Gbps network backbone to bring in all these data guzzling cameras into the command center, sir. Sir, integration is key, like I've told you. Just I want to put in a glimpse of what and all systems are integrated to bring in one system. While I'm talking about crime and criminal database of the national database is integrated, we have got RTO databases, jail systems, we have AI-based picture intelligence unit, CAD, our passenger citizen guidance systems like VMDs, passenger public administration systems, call boxes, ATCC, challoning system, vehicle tracking license plate recognition. We are also in discussion with some of the departments like GHMC, Outer Ring Road, Metro and community cameras to integrate more and more as and when the need comes into the either local police stations or to the integrated operations centers, sir. Sir, of course, you also keep talking a lot about the artificial intelligence leverage and all. Sir, the key thing here is that all these things is, one is integration and infrastructure. The most important thing is how do I build the intelligence over here using technology. And this intelligence is not for, again, the command centers, but it is to the field officers. So we have got big data correlation using crime and criminal stitch on the national database, which means that, sir, any crime happens, for example, a chain snatching happens in one event. At real time, the people over here know exactly who could have been those offenders, maybe one or two or three suspects based on the historical data, and they actually give it to the investigating officers so that it doesn't take a week's time. It happens probably in few seconds, really, to go and nab them, sir. We have got AI recommendation engines on pattern routes and crimes where we keep recommending. Sir, if you see, this is all recommendation engines. They don't go and do actual action on the ground. It is left to the field officer for his judgment. Third thing is, we are doing a lot of machine learning on traffic violation detection. We have got to set up a data lake, sir, which is actually wherein multiple data sources can come in. This is where we can leverage data sources coming in multiple other departments also for actually effective processing on this. We are using deep learning, for example, pothole detection and facial recognition, which is actually work in place now. I mean, quite a couple of police stations have started using on pothole, and facial recognition we have been using for some time, mostly from criminal identification point of view. And we also have geospatial intelligence, especially for route predictions on the patrolling or common city asset database. All these things are actually provided by Telangana State Police AI Center of Excellence, which is the core of this particular system. Sir, what does this particular center do when we say integrated operations center? One of the key things is, like we are talking about, we need to provide real-time situational awareness through fusion of data from CCTVs, various other data sources, geospatial information, and various IoT sensors. All these things together fused to make some sense out of it and given to the field officers at real time. And this is what actually this center does. Number two, it also provides integrated view of all the three functions of policing: emergency, traffic, and law enforcement, because they all actually get integrated at the process level. And number three is empowerment of field officers through real-time insights and act and resolve for citizen delight. Sir, at the end of the day, this particular IOC actually here acts as a brain for all the command centers and field officers to keep continuously providing the insights. At a broad level, these are the functions this particular center does, sir. One is incident and emergency management, law and order functions like collaborative monitoring, crime and criminal analysis, intelligence, push through some messages to the citizens on the ground. Similarly, in traffic management, we do enforcement. Traffic simulation analysis is what we are continuously doing. We are continuously working using data-driven junction management, signal planning and optimization, and we are also having vehicle hotlisting and tracking for any known and offender vehicles throughout the city. All these functions together are going to be done in this particular place, with preventive policing as one of the core outcome. Unified incident response, sir, we don't actually wait for whether social media or grievance or dial 100. All are actually coming and landing in one place. Quicker investigation, sir, some of the investigation which I will demonstrate. For example, to see a CCTV footage, we may take 8 hours to 10 hours really in NAB. Here we can do in seconds. That I will also demonstrate that. And there is enforcement, which Hyderabad is very well known for effective implementation of automated enforcement. And junction engineering is what we are working here, sir. This actually is the integrated operations center, this particular center does. Effectively, if I were to call, this is going to be the brain of these whole systems. And there's a slight difference, sir. Normally, command centers are treated to be more surveillance systems, but this is more of an intelligence system. And the command centers will focus more on local investigation and local incident management. This will provide the required intelligence. Sir, but to do this, I just want to put a glimpse. We have brought in the world's best technology coming from North America, either Canada or USA. Some of these systems are even implemented by NYPD, so that they are proven systems. We have gone to Europe, especially working with some of these players in Sweden. We're going to Japan, Italy, Israel. But most important thing is, sir, while bringing all these systems together and integrating, the top one is we need to solve local problems. That is where actually we have been working with the Telangana State Police to use these technologies to solve local problems, which is very, very important, sir. This is something which is a learning for us, because every time we bring in world best systems and stitch, it doesn't serve the purpose. So here we are happy to say you that we have got a center of excellence which solves local problems. For example, pothole is not a problem anywhere in the world with these systems, but we will be able to do that using the same infrastructure. So this is what actually, so global partners and local solutions. Sir, from the future roadmap, what actually we are working is there are two fronts, sir. I'm happy to say you that we have been also working towards supporting Telangana's initiative of Year of Artificial Intelligence. So we started working on data mining, crime analytics, crime prediction analytics, social media mining, and video synopsis analytics. There are different levels of maturity, but we are working on this, sir. We have got a dedicated team of 15 people working only on this, working with the police officers on what actually is useful on the ground. Some of the technologies, not only just the video, the data, geospatial information, NLP, IoT, and all these things are brought in together. So there is a bit of good amount of dose of technology, but ultimately to do these things using the latest technologies. Sir, some of the social media one, you have been also been appreciative for Medaram Jatra there. And the top corner one is what we are actually received an award for FIRA Barcelona in terms of one of the best projects in top right corner, sir. Sir, there is also another one. While we are setting up so much infrastructure and technology, one of the drive which DGP was pushing us is, can we leverage this infrastructure and this technology for other departments and same vice versa? That is where actually we are talking about multi-agency operations center, sir. We've been working on this for the last couple of years. The vision that is set is enable seamless coordination between multiple departments by sharing critical resources and information through secure technology, because it all deals with data, so secure technology, thereby improving individual department service level. So it actually improves the governance levels, especially when there is multi-departmental agency happens, coordination happens. At the end of the day, as a whole, at cutting edge in an intern citizen delight. So if you see, citizen is the center for this governance services. This is achieved through coordination, information sharing, analytics, communication, knowledge management. Sir, actually, as city of Hyderabad, when it comes to emergency situation, I think people do come together and do most of these things. But this has to be brought in either to process, people and technology at the normal day level. That is the intention of this particular thing, sir. And there's a big framework. I will not go through fully, but we have done some work, sir. Basically, the objective is to empowerment of departments, continuous monitoring and citizen delight for normal day and emergency day of various functions, with enablers as situational awareness, actionable intelligence, and geographical awareness, and outcomes as better asset utilization. For example, sir, if a calamity happens or a house collapses, finding where a gas cutter is a big thing at that point of time, because normally the first responders are from police, they go there. If we are able to bring that to a common database, it is available to all the authorities, whoever wants to access, it could be fire, municipality, or disaster and emergency response teams, or even for our police. Similarly, improved service delivery, give one common operating picture, because sometimes a traffic jam happens, the other may not be knowing, fire stations may not be knowing, and they'll be getting through that roads. And ultimately, citizen delight. With the pillars of people, process, infrastructure, and technology are the pillars for this one, sir. So we've been working on this. What we did in, sir, taking into consideration of what police has got at this point of time, that is the data in terms of congestion data, traffic road data in terms of vehicle density and all those things what we are measuring. We have integrated with Ola and Uber also in terms of the journeys that are happening, especially from the emergency management. We have got number plate recognitions, safety, geospatial information, and very important things are citizen services, that is the message boards and public announcement systems. How can we actually leverage them to communicate more with the citizens in terms of any calamity or any information, social awareness and all those things from central place? All these things or property of the government can be utilized for various other use cases with other departments. It could be probably for tracking vehicles, it could be tracking for, you know, some of the command centers like GHMC and ORR, we can integrate with them. Potholes, which will also help. Traffic congestion broadcasting, common city GIS database, quite a few use cases can be really worked out using this information, which will be useful to the municipal authorities as well. So these things can be done, they're all available, and the infrastructure is available. We need to put in the right framework and process to start actually sharing with the other departments who want to consume. Yeah. Go back. Yes, next. Sir, we also did some study in terms of, we had meetings with various other departments. What could be the data which generally that is requested by other departments for seamless integration and coordination between the departments? Municipality has got, they have come up with certain data points that can be shared. Same with the track, that is on the GIS side. Security, the police one, utilities has actually have shared the data already in terms of what actually we can be using. For example, sir, if we have got the utility database and some communication has to be sent, if we have got all the contact details, we can send communication details depending on the geography and all those things. Then traffic data is there, railway data is there, you know, some of the, you know, left-wing extremism data is there. All these things can be utilized in terms of multiple departments. This is what was envisaged as a future roadmap, sir. Sir, with this, I will take some time to start the demonstration. I will start a demonstration of some of these technologies we have done, sir. Yes. Sir, first of all, I'll start off with law and order management in terms of what actually we have put in. Sir, typically in any incident management, somebody calls, we take the call and it goes dispatches and somebody goes and does and actually goes there without really knowing what actually that issue is. But the system we have implemented is the moment somebody calls, for example, now somebody is going to call from one of the ECBs, SOS box set up in the city, I think somewhere near Rasulpura. Yeah. Can you call? So this is a CAD system, sir. What happens is the call lands over here. I've just put something.
Thank you for calling there,
landed.
So one of our employees actually in the field, sir. She is actually talking to the operator over here. So she is the one talking there, sir. Actually, we got the call now. I just wanted to simulate it. The moment we get it, what happens, sir? There's a camera there. I can see around the surroundings as well. What's happening and what is the distress there? Now we know the location, we know the place from where she is calling, and the call taker just takes the call and says that, you know, don't worry, be there, I'm going to come there. Okay. Typically, yeah. Next. Yeah, submit it to the dispatch officer. So the moment this is dispatched, what happens is before I dispatch it, now I need to see what's happening around the city. See, the one what you see in the blue are our cameras, sir. The one what you see in the pink is the incident, just now the call which has come in. And the one red is another incident that is there. So I know exactly from which location it has come, and the, probably it is like chain snatching there, and we are waiting there for the action there. Yeah. Sir, if you see here, this is again a unique feature implemented only in the Chicago at this point of time. Wherein what we are doing is, based on the incident that has come, based on the modus operandi of the crime, we are able to filter out all the historical crimes that would have happened in that area. For example, a chain snatching doing from front or from the back, or which area. Based on that, we are actually able to find out all the cameras in that area at real time. This is available not only to this center, sir, it is available right up to the field officer to the ground. Everybody has got same access of information. And then we actually can find out who are those potential criminals, okay, who actually would have been operating in that area for that particular crime. And this comes from the National Criminal Database, historical database. And then we do some amount of filtering and recommendation on that based on the criminal activity earlier. Then we also know all the vehicles that are operating in that area, if at all something has happened. So I know exactly in that incident, at that point of time, what vehicles would have passed through and what are those numbers and who are there, because I'm connected to the national database on the vehicles as well as on the state database. And then we also know the situational awareness, what other incidents other people would have called. Normally chain snatching does not happen once, maybe 2-3 places in one place. So we get all that information together. So the dispatching officer exactly knows what actually would have happened at that point of time, even before actually allocating this job to somebody on the ground. Now, With this, sir, what we will do is we actually go to the field officer and then we allocate this to the officer there. Yeah. So this is the first one, sir. Yeah, go ahead. Sir, what we do is we actually dispatch this to the concerned patrolling officer. Sir, the unique thing that actually comes over here is go ahead. Okay, I'll keep talking, sir, in the meantime. So what happens is actually here, as soon as we get that, we get to know what all the nearest patrolling officers who are available within the range of that particular thing, and dispatch officer immediately assigns this particular thing to that particular dispatch officer, wherein he can reach probably within the, 2 or 3 or 4 minutes depending on the traffic conditions, sir. Yeah, we'll go to the next one. This is the patrolling vehicles and the distance they are there. So dynamically we can allocate there itself, sir, in terms of this one. If you see it is 2.3 kilometers, immediately we can dispatch that particular officer there. Sir, if it is really an emergency call, what we do is we skip all this process. Directly the call goes to the nearest patrolling vehicle without actually going through this call taking process to cut down the time. Yeah, let's go ahead. Sir, when these incidents come, this is what actually I'm talking about. Irrespective of where the incident comes, it comes into one place. So we have one incident management system. For example, the incident that has come here, now this is integrated with the cameras, with the social media data, whatever comes as a grievance. So we actually take from here, and then we will be able to have the SOPs defined. They will be able to use this checklist in terms of what to act. For example, somebody has to check a suspected vehicle, there's a checklist over there. Beyond this checklist, what we also can see, what are the related incidents in that particular area happening at that point of time for a common operating picture. We also can actually see what are the related entities. For example, sir, for this particular incident, I may really want to add a couple of cameras, maybe a 1 hour footage, so that the investigation officer can start working on that, which otherwise he will be losing time again finding out where it has happened. I can do that and then push it back to the investigation officers on the ground. And then we also can have a lot of documents actually uploaded there. We can upload an evidence if something I get either through a mobile phone as a picture or whatever it is, I actually put that. Sir, what it actually tells is we have got a system now wherein the incident is actually bringing in the evidences, the cameras, everything together for a seamless investigation so that we save a lot of time in terms of the investigation. Yeah. Yes. Sir, while we are also doing this, I've been talking about this command centers. Command centers typically take a CCTV type of view, but what we have done is it has also got incident management functionality. But I'll just talk about the video function, sir, because all the functionality what I've talked is available in command centers also. Here, this is a normal video functionality which we can see, but what is important, sir, here is, if you see the yellow one, they're all community cameras. And the one which is in orange color, they're all government cameras. And the one which is black, there are PTZ cameras which can see a 360 degrees view. This is something which is very unique in the country, sir. Normally CCTV cameras on community side, either the community will monitor or maybe sometimes nearest police station monitor. Here we are bringing in all together to see seamlessly. There are many narrow locations within the city where the government camera may not be there. So we will use those cameras either which are of the retail shops looking at the roads or even most of the things, sir. Sir, go ahead. The next one. Sir, we can also see this jurisdiction-based access. It is not about the cameras are available to everybody. For example, if it's Panjagutta police station, we have a view to the operators in Panjagutta to operate within their area so that there is an audit access and restriction in terms of what they are doing. But if there's a cross-jurisdiction analysis, the station house officer will have access to most of the other jurisdictions there. Yeah. Let's move on. Sir, here we also have another feature which is very important is whenever we are planning a VIP route, normally we need to identify which cameras, which route and all. Here we can group all together and see all the locations in the VIP route at one point of time to provide better security services. For example, we have picked up just now Honorable CM's camp office area in terms of that route. All the cameras around actually can be monitored by the police authorities at one shot you know, without really, you know, running around, you know, which camera is where and in what route. Yeah, let's move on. Sir, this is a very, very important one, especially useful feature. No city in India is implemented. Sir, whenever an incident happens, normally we would take 8 to 10, 12 hours to really go through the footage and identify where the issue is. Here, what we have done is, what normally takes in hours, we can do in seconds. For example, typically what happens, sir, we have got some analytics set up in the system. If somebody leaves an unidentified baggage near a public place, system picks up the alert without any police, without any dial 100, picks up the alert. Now, how do I quickly actually react to that? What happens, sir, is that now I cannot go keep going and looking at the footage, which will take hours together. What we do is we pick this up. I say bag is my point of interest. With this, I will be able to bring down 6 hour footage to say 11:17 to 12:29. I know exactly when this image would have changed. I keep drilling down, keep going, 12:27. 12:27 here, probably in few seconds, somebody would have come and put that one. Sir, if you see this, this is what actually happens. Somebody has come here with 3145 vehicle, put in the bag and is left. This exercise would have taken 8 to 10 hours for us to do that. We can do in few seconds over here. This is very, very useful in terms of investigation. Now, what happens, sir, when certain thing like that happens? You would want to see in around the cameras what is happening at the same time. Okay, really to do the investigation. So what we can do is, I pick up this camera, and at the same time when the bag was put, I actually add multiple cameras, for example, in these three areas, and try to do a time sync at that point of time, what is happening in all those areas, you know, without really worrying about going to multiple cameras. All these things, at this point of time, they come to the command center to take the footage. But here, these are all delivered to the local police stations. So that's the beauty of the system, sir. So now I know, at that point of time, what is happening in all these systems, and they do a faster investigation. Suppose a car would have come, that would, they would have definitely would have passed in this direction, and we know exactly in which route is going. Yeah. So some of this in the city surveillance use cases, one of the key things is improve the conviction probability, which is the most important thing. When you improve the conviction probability, evidence is one of the most important feature. Collecting evidence in a larger system like this, will always be difficult. So what we do is, for example, this is one of the case that has come in, we've gotten from the FIR system. We have actually associated one camera about 1 hour footage into that. Now, I suspect this is one, I pushed it. Now, investigation officer need not spend a lot of time really to identify, he'll keep focusing on that 1 hour to really get the clues. Yeah. The second thing is, sir, is that here, while you are doing investigation, you may also want to do a lot of bookmarking, saying that, look, I need to come back here and then see whether it makes sense, especially during the investigation process. We have that bookmarking facility. This is again very unique. Doing at a city scale, that's very, very important. So I can do a bookmarking. So the other important thing is, normally we delete the videos after 30 days. Here, if there is something useful for evidence, we protect the video for whatever the time we define. Some videos can be infinite as, you know, until the court case happens. So it could be 5 days or indefinite. We protect that system. So evidence is captured and then protected is the most important thing. Now the second thing is, sir, while we are doing these things, yeah, good. Yeah. So while we are doing these things, we also have all these incidents in a particular city, what is happening in a geographical view. Yeah, good. Sir, if you see here, the bag incident which I was talking about, nobody has called for that. Actually, our system was able to pick up and report to the command center that somebody has put a bag as an alert. And the fallout of that was the rest of the investigation which I was talking about. Yeah. This is again, normally video cameras, if you put on the map, you get exactly come to know which area, which route the offenders probably are traveling. We'll be able to see all real-time entry exit cameras, which is very, very useful during investigation and conviction. Sir, what we also do the use cases over here is, we identify stopped use vehicles, unidentified objects, any unplanned traffic congestion, crowd management. Sir, during COVID, some of these markets, especially Sunday markets, they used to get crowded a lot. So we have got 700 cameras looking at those places and alert saying that there's a crowd forming here, and then police was able to immediately go and educate them. So that's what actually was happening over here, sir. Yes, next, quick one. Sir, last on the surveillance side, on the CCTV side, While we are talking about all those things, most of the times what happens is whether the video is genuine or not is always an issue. So what we do is we can watermark them and provide the encryption there. For example, I have got two tampered videos there actually. I can tell you that now whether it's tampered or not, you know, it's good. It exactly tells me that it's already tampered. So anybody who's playing around with the video, if I put into system, I exactly know it's watermarked. If it's tampered, I'll come to know. This is very useful during the evidencing purpose, sir. Yeah, good. We can also now, encryption, sir, there's a password there. It is a 128-bit encryption, so nobody will be able to do unless the key is known. Last but not least, sir, there's a role-based access and audit because this video has to be available only to the selected people in terms of the roles, either investigation officers or the command center operators. So based on that, there is a role-based access, there is an audit also available in the system. Yeah. Sir, I'll quickly move into traffic management. So this is, I mean, Hyderabad has been well known in terms of providing automated enforcement more than any other city, because I also work closely with Mumbai city, sir. Here it is very, very effective. On an average, depending on the day, there could be anywhere between 5,000 to 25,000 type of violations coming in. But here what we do is, sir, that we actually are focusing in the traffic management, not just for chalani, but reduction in road accidents, decrease in overall travel time, and some enforcement from the civic discipline point of view, and thereby citizen delight. Sir, here we actually have around 200 plus places these enforcements are in place. So all these, they are being tracked either for red light violations, stop line violations, speed, no helmet detection, and so on and so forth. So all are done automatically. These alerts, most of the cities in India, what they do, sir, they go and challan and send to the central place, and they do e-challaning. Here we get the challans automatically, and there is a verification, mandatory verification for the evidence, and then it gets pushed. So there is no human intervention at all from the challaning point of view. Sir, for example, if we are doing speed, sir, maybe we can show the speed, you know, I'll just show you somebody who has traveled more than 80 kilometers speed. Yeah, just let us search for that. Yeah, there are a lot of people who travel more than 80 kilometers in the city. Especially during night times. If I pick up one of those, I think we get around three images with a video for evidence point of view tomorrow if they challenge in the court. But this is exactly, it's very accurate system, sir, and it stands in the evaluation. Yeah, see that, sir. So these things are packed, so quite a few, happen, sir. What also happens is, since we look at this number plate, many times number plates go wrong because the way they are in. So we have this machine learning wherein we do supervised learning where we will keep teaching it. Next time when this number plate comes to how to actually identify it. So that also keeps happening, sir. This purely works on machine learning. Next one. Yeah, that's fine. Next. Sir, this is a dashboard which I just want to show you on the enforcement. Currently, the traffic system is only for Hyderabad. So Hyderabad and Ratchakonda we are implementing. It will be done by around February. If you see here, Hyderabad, most of the violations are coming in the one which is in the deep red, the less are on the lighter red actually, at a broader level. Yeah, next one. Yeah, next. So there is also another feature here. If you see some of these cars who are hotlisted, means for example, police will say this is the offender's vehicle and we hotlisted. So we exactly know where and all this person is actually moving the city. So for example, one vehicle is probably found almost 600 times. In a given 2 or 3 months time. So we based on this, we will be able to know where is he going, on what day is going, and when on what days he goes where, it can be done. But this is done in a very, 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 the processes and systems are in place for this, sir. Just like that, anybody cannot monitor these vehicles. There is an approval process here. Yeah, that's more. So this is the important one. I'll spend some time here, sir. Sir, we have put in around 170 places the automatic traffic counting and classification sensors, which actually measure the type of the vehicles, number of lanes that are formed, and the queue lengths are formed near the junctions. This actually also gives us the speeds, average speeds, for every second there that's happening there. This actually data is very useful, two things, sir. One is for us to make the traffic junctions very intelligent, which we are working on. Once the signaling, new signal comes in, we are going to implement that, sir. And the second important thing is this data is useful to the traffic planning and road works part also. This is very valuable because the data that is coming from Google and all are pretty, approximated, sir. This is the right data. For example, if you see in this junction, we have the green one, which is the lifetime high. The one which is blue is the typical day, and today's day is, traffic is very low actually in the particular area. This helps us to plan the capacities of the road. And on the traffic side, sir, if you see here, these arms here, the yellow one, actually tells you the capacity that is being full. If it turns red, we know that the capacity of that road is, at that point of time, is full. Immediately we will be able to take some actions on that, sir. So this is a very unique feature which is implemented only in our place in Hyderabad. No city has implemented, sir. So we can also do about a lot of traffic incident management, wherein we know, if there is an incident happens, how do we respond to that particular incident? Go for it. Keep going. So we'll be able to identify which lanes can be blocked, and the beauty of the system is, sir, from here, system will be able to tell what message should go to the message display boards, which will guide the citizens either to take a detour or to take a normal route, sir. Move on, next one. See, we have this hotlisting vehicles detection, sir, in the system, and we'll be able to identify which vehicle is going where, and help the policing authorities. This is accessible only to the specified authorized officers only. Next one. Keep moving. So this is what our AI Center of Excellence started doing, sir. Sir, in the normal patrolling function, which is the core of any policing, normally what we keep doing based on the experience and intelligence, we keep creating point books wherein police officer is supposed to go there, go around for 50 minutes, gather the intelligence, connect to the community, and then come back and go to the next place. Typically what happens over a period of time is, sir, that it goes in a routine, we keep adding more and more point books, and there will be a time wherein 1 kilometer you may have 150 point books sort of thing. But what we started doing is using this data of historical crimes, local intelligence, and the incidents that are happening, is there a way, best patrolling route that can be recommended to the policing officers? That is what actually we are working on, sir. If you see here, the blue one is the jurisdiction, the one which is in green are the crime clusters which we need to actually add in. So this is already in place. We are actually now using this in the Rai Durgam police station, sir. So this is a very unique feature. No city anywhere in the world has implemented this, sir. This is how we are using. What we will be doing more and more in this patrolling is, we'll keep giving more and more augmented intelligence to the field officer on this. Next one. So this is one, you see, this is a real-time information. What we planned is the green one and the jurisdiction over here, and the vehicles are actually going around. Next one. So this is something which we have done. We using the same infrastructure of the police, the CCTVs, can we really measure if there are any potholes which are creating the accidents so that they can be immediately addressed? With these cameras, we are able to get the potholes with a reasonable amount of accuracy. Around 679 cameras are watching, around 130 potholes are there. And obviously, these keep changing depending on how we operate on. But this data is available. For example, some of these things are actually here. Sir, some of these things we'll be able to show them, the potholes there. So for example, some of these things will be identified, sir. So this information, it's being disseminated to the authorities to take further action on that, sir. With this, I would like to thank you, sir, for this opportunity, and this is the overall system we have. Thank you.
So here it is. The center will gather and provide the right intelligence at the right time to ensure the safety of the citizens. Thank you, JVS, for outlining the details. Going to the next program on the agenda, skilling and reskilling is the mantra to keep up with the ever-changing technology. Telangana Police and the Department of IT-ENC, Government of Telangana, are entering into an MOU to train the police force in cybersecurity. Can we have the table, please? Thank you. May I invite Sri Jayesh Ranjan, Principal Secretary, IT-ENC Department, Government of Telangana, and Sri Mahendra Reddy Garu, Director General of Police, Telangana State, to sign the MOU. And may I invite Dr. Sriram Biruduvolu, CEO of CCOE, to join here, please. Thank you so very much. May I now invite the guest of honor, Honorable Minister for Home, Sri Mahmood Ali Garu, to address the gathering.
Honorable Minister of IT Industries, MAUD, Sri K.T. Rama Rao Garu, Honorable Minister of Education, Srimati P. Sabita Indra Reddy Garu, Sthanika MLA Arkipudu Gandhi Garu, Ma Mayor Garu, Buntu Rahman Garu, MLC Sri Naveen Kumar Garu, Sri Jayesh Ranjan Garu, Principal Secretary of IT, Sri Damodar Garu, Chairman of Housing Corporation, Sri M. Mahindra Reddy Garu, DG of Police, all Muguru Commissioners, Anjani Kumar Garu, Mahesh Babu, Mahesh Bhagwat Garu, Sajnar Garu, other IPS officers, L&T technicians, distinguished guests, media friends, ladies and gentlemen, andariki namaskaram. I am happy that the Public Safety Integrated Operation Center and Data Center by the Telangana State Police is inaugurated by none other than our dynamic IT Minister Sri K. Tariq Rama Garu. We all know that government have taken up the Hyderabad Safe and Smart City project with the sole objective of citizen-friendly, holistic, integrated and responsive CCTV system for three commissionates, Hyderabad, Cyberabad and Rachakunda. The main center of this project is this Telangana Police Public Safety Integrated Operations Center and Data Center. This center will host integrated operations, command, computer, added call taking and dispatching, and provide single view of our 10,000 government cameras and integrated our 1 lakh community cameras. This center provides cutting edge technologies like computer vision, facial recognition, cyber security, and a state the art data center with 44 servers, racks for video storage. Gaurav Mukhyamantri Garu, Sri Kalvakonta Chandrasekhar Garu, Modati Nundi, Police Shakaku, Pradhanyatanu, Istunaru, Telangana Rashtamlo, Shantri Badratala, Parikshanaku, Policing Nu, Marinta, Merugu, Parishidaniki, Aneka Charyalaku, Sikaram, Chuttaru, Police Department Ku, Avasara Maina, Nidulu, Alat Chesaru. ఈ రోజు దేశంలోని ఇతర రాష్ట్రాల కన్నా మన రాష్ట్రంలో క్రైమ్ రేట్ తక్కువగా ఉంది. పోలీస్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్లో అవసరమైన స్ట్రెంత్ కోసం గత 5 సంవత్సరాల్లో దాదాపు 28,000 మంది కానిస్టేబుల్ మరియు ఎస్ఐలను రిక్రూట్ చేశాం. పోలీస్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ కు లాంటి మొబిలిటీ అండ్ విజిబిలిటీ ని ఇంప్రూవ్ చేయడానికి దాదాపు 700 కోట్లు కేటాయించి నూతన వాహనాలు సమకూర్చాం. తెలంగాణ రాష్ట్ర పోలీసింగ్ లో ఇన్నోవేటివ్ ఇనిషియేటివ్స్ తెచ్చింది. టెక్నాలజీని పూర్తి స్థాయిలో యూజ్ చేస్తున్నాం. హైదరాబాద్ బంజారాహిల్స్ లో స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆర్ట్ టెక్నాలజీతో నిర్మిస్తున్నాం. ఇంటిగ్రేటెడ్ పోలీస్ కమాండ్ అండ్ కంట్రోల్ సెంటర్ చివరి దశలో ఉంది. ఈ సెంటర్ త్వరలో రాష్ట్రానికి అధునాతన సేవలు అందిస్తుంది. ఈరోజు అనేక సిటిజన్స్ సెంట్రిక్ స్కీమ్స్ వల్ల మన పోలీస్ శాఖ దేశంలోని ఇతర రాష్ట్రాలకు రోల్ మోడల్గా మారింది. క్రైమ్ ప్రివెన్షన్ కోసం, పబ్లిక్ ప్లేసెస్ పర్యవేక్షణ కోసం సీసీటీవీలను ఉపయోగించే నగరాల్లో హైదరాబాద్ ఫోర్ ఫ్రంట్లో ఉంది. హైదరాబాద్, సైబరాబాద్ మరియు రాచకొండలలోనే 5 లక్షలకు పైగా సీసీటీవీ కెమెరాలు ఉన్నాయి. 2019లో ఇంటర్నేషనల్ టాప్ 20 నగరాల్లో హైదరాబాద్ సిటీ 16వ స్థానాన్ని కలిగి ఉంది. యూకేకు చెందిన ఒక సర్వే పేర్కొంది హైదరాబాద్లో ప్రతి 1,000 మందికి 30 కెమెరాస్ ఉన్నాయి. ఈరోజు రాష్ట్రంలో డైల్ 100 సమర్థవంతంగా పనిచేస్తుంది. కేవలం 5 నిమిషాల సమయంలో క్రైమ్ స్పాట్కు చేరుకుంటుంది. ఇది నేను చెబుతున్నది కాదు, మీడియా వారు ఇతరులు దీనిని ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ చేసి చేశారు. పాస్పోర్ట్ వెరిఫికేషన్ కూడా 3 to 4 డేస్లో పూర్తి చేస్తూ రికార్డ్ స్పష్టించాం. దీనికి కేంద్ర ప్రభుత్వం నుండి 4 సంవత్సరాలు వెరీ ఫాస్ట్ అవార్డు వచ్చింది. గౌరవ ముఖ్యమంత్రి గారు ఉమెన్ సేఫ్టీకి అధికి ప్రాధాన్యతను ఇచ్చారు. స్పెషల్గా ఉమెన్ సేఫ్టీ వింగ్ ఏర్పాటు చేశాం, షీ టీమ్స్ ఏర్పాటు చేశాం. రాష్ట్రంలో మహిళలకు భద్రత కల్పిస్తున్నాం. మన షీ టీమ్స్ను అదర్ స్టేట్ వాళ్ళు కూడా స్టడీ చేసి ఇంప్లిమెంట్ చేస్తున్నారు. అడ్వాన్స్ టెక్నాలజీ వినియోగం, ఫ్రెండ్లీ పోలీసింగ్ మొదలగు చర్యలు వల్ల గత 6 సంవత్సరాల్లో రాష్ట్రంలో ఏ విధమైన మేజర్ హింసాత్మక సంఘటన జరగలేదు. ముఖ్యంగా హైదరాబాద్ మహానగరంలో గత 6 సంవత్సరాలుగా ఏదే విధమైన క్రిమినల్ వైలెన్స్ ఘర్షణలు జరగలేదు. దసరా, దీపావళి, బోనాలు, గణేష్ ఉత్సవాలు, రంజాన్, బక్రీద్, మొహరం తదితర పండుగలన్నీ ఎంతో సేఫ్గా నిర్వహించుకోవడంలో పోలీస్ శాఖ కృషి ఎంతగానో ఉంది. తెలంగాణ వచ్చే తర్వాత మా ఆనుభూ సీఎం గారు చాలా గంగాజమున తైజీపు ఇంప్రూవ్ చేశారు. మన దగ్గర రంజాన్ పండుగ, బోనాల్ పండుగ, క్రిస్మస్ పండుగలో సీఎం గారు చాలా ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఇచ్చారు. ఫెస్టివల్లో గవర్నమెంట్ ద్వారా ఎంత సహాయత కావాలి అంత మా సీఎం గారు చేస్తున్నారు. మా ఆనరబుల్ సీఎం గారు పోలీస్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ద్వారా చాలా బాగా ల్యాండ్ ఆర్డర్ కంట్రోల్ చేసినాకు చాలా వాచ్ చేస్తున్నారు. తెలంగాణ వచ్చే ముందు అందరికీ ఒక డౌట్ ఉంది, తెలంగాణ వచ్చిన తర్వాత ల్యాండ్ ఆర్డర్ ఎట్లా కంట్రోల్ అవుతుంది. మా పోలీస్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్కు చాలా మా థ్యాంక్స్ చెప్తున్నాను. చాలా బాగా మీరు కంట్రోల్ చేశారు. మ్యాక్సిమం మా ఆనరబుల్ సీఎం గారు మంచి పాలసీ అడాప్ట్ చేసిన తర్వాత ఇది ల్యాండ్ ఆర్డర్లో బాగా కంట్రోల్ ఉంది. ఇప్పుడు ఇండియాలో 1 ల్యాండ్ ఆర్డర్, 1 పోలీస్ అంటే మా స్టేట్లో ఉంది. ఈ టైంలో చాలా మా పేరంటే బాగా ఇది గౌరవ ఐటీ మినిస్టర్ ఇండస్ట్రీస్ ఎంఐయుడి మంత్రి శ్రీ కేటీ రామారావు గారి ఆధ్వర్యంలో తెలంగాణ రాష్ట్ర ఐటీ అండ్ ఇండస్ట్రియల్ డెవలప్మెంట్లో చాలా పెరుగుతుంది సాధించింది. ఇండియాలో మన స్టేట్లో చాలా ఇండస్ట్రీస్ వస్తున్నారు. Honorable Minister KTR Garu, Chala Varjeshe, Chala Dynamic Leader Unnaru, Chala Industries, Mana State Lo Vastundi, Employment Jarugutundi, Chala Mana Development Vastundi. Andaru other state lo manchi, ikkada vache tarvata naato kalise oka mata cheptunnaru. Sir, ikkada Hyderabad lo chala baga land order undi, ratri 12 gantalaku bayata pote, chala manaku mana safe unnaru, naku em bhayam ledu. Today I am glad that inauguration of this center will benefit law enforcement through preventive policing, speedy investigation, automated violation enforcement, smart policing, and create safe and secure communities, and also help the integrated traffic management and impressive quality of life of citizens. On the occasion, I appreciate and congratulate the DGP and three commissioners of police and all other police officers of the police department for early completion of this center, which will surely provide responsive police service to the people. I also appreciate Sri Jayesh Ranjan Garu, Principal Secretary, IT, for his support and help. Ee roju maa IT Minister Garu, KT Ramarao Garu, ee roju idi inaugurate chesaru center ki chaala manaku santoshanga unnanu. Ippudu maa Education Minister Sabita Madam Reddy Garu, Sabita Reddy Garu, Indira Reddy Garu, attend chesaru. Ayana ku bi nenu chaala thanks cheptunnaru. Maa MLA Garu ku, MLC Garu ku, maa Chairman Garu ku, andariki properly, maa technicians ki andariki peru pedutunnanu, thanks cheptunnaru. Inta fast level lo ee building tayarindi. Inata chaala land order ku support vastundi, chaala land order control ayyindi. Traffic kosam ippudu watch chesaru, chaala camera dwara chaala baaga control chesina avakashu. Andariki peru pedutu థ్యాంక్స్, నమస్కారం.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్. ద నెక్స్ట్ స్పీకర్, హీ డెఫినెట్లీ డజన్ నీడ్ అన్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్. హిస్ ఎయిమ్ ఇస్ టు మేక్ అ మార్క్ ఫర్ హైదరాబాద్ ఆన్ ద ఐటీ మ్యాప్ ఆఫ్ ద వరల్డ్, ప్రోయాక్టివ్ అండ్ విజనరీ. సో ఐ రిపీట్, ప్రోయాక్టివ్ అండ్ విజనరీ, దట్స్ కేటీఆర్ గారు. May I invite the chief guest of the day, Shri K.T. Ramarao Garu, Honorable Minister for IT, ENC, Municipal Administration, Urban Development, Industries and Commerce, to address the gathering.
Good afternoon. Gauravaneeyulu mana Rashtra Home Shaka Mantrivaryulu Peddalu Mohammad Mehmood Ali Garu, Gauravaneeyulu Rashtra విద్యాశాఖ మంత్రివర్యులు శ్రీమతి సబితా ఇంద్రారెడ్డి గారు, గౌరవనీయులు గవర్నమెంట్ విప్ స్థానిక శాసనసభ్యులు ఆరికపూడి గాంధీ గారు, గౌరవ శాసన మండలి సభ్యులు మిత్రులు నవీన్ కుమార్ గారు, నగర మేయర్ సోదరుడు బొంతు రామ్మోహన్ గారు, పోలీస్ హౌసింగ్ కార్పొరేషన్ అధ్యక్షులు కోలెట్టి దామోదర్ గారు, గౌరవనీయులు తెలంగాణ రాష్ట్ర డైరెక్టర్ జనరల్ ఆఫ్ పోలీస్ మహేందర్ రెడ్డి గారు, గౌరవనీయులు మా ఐటీ సెక్రటరీ జయేష్ రంజన్ గారు, హోమ్ సెక్రటరీ గారు, అదే రకంగా డైరెక్టర్ జనరల్స్ ఆఫ్ పోలీస్, ఆల్ ద కమిషనర్స్ ఆఫ్ పోలీస్ అండ్ సునీల్ శర్మ గారు మన ప్రిన్సిపల్ సెక్రటరీ రోడ్స్ అండ్ బిల్డింగ్స్ అండ్ ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్ అండ్ ఆల్ ద సీనియర్ ఆఫీసర్స్ హూ గ్యాదర్డ్ హియర్. అదే రకంగా ఈరోజు ఐటీ రంగానికి సంబంధించిన వివిధ సంస్థల నుండి ఇక్కడ విచ్చేసిన ఐటీ కంపెనీ సిఇఓస్కి, అదే రకంగా సైబరాబాద్ సెక్యూరిటీ కౌన్సిల్ యొక్క కార్యవర్గ సభ్యులకి, ఐసీఆ అధ్యక్షుడు భరణి గారు, ఇంకా వారితో పాటు విచ్చేసిన మిత్రులందరికీ, పాత్రికేయ మిత్రులందరికీ హృదయపూర్వకంగా నమస్కారాలు. ముందుగా ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు కంగ్రాచులేట్ ఆనరబుల్ హోమ్ మినిస్టర్, ఆనరబుల్ డీజీపీ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ టీమ్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ పోలీస్ ఆన్ లాంచింగ్ ఇండియాస్ ఫస్ట్ అండ్ మోస్ట్ కాంప్రిహెన్సివ్ ఇంటిగ్రేటెడ్ ఆపరేషన్ సెంటర్ focused on public safety. I think the key word here is public safety, because whatever we are doing today, whatever has been launched today, the key underlining theme or underlining point here is that it is centered around public and their well-being. My experience, you know, with respect to law and order in the city నేను ఇక్కడే చిన్నప్పుడు చదువుకున్నాను. నేను హైదరాబాద్లో పుట్టలేదు. లైక్ మెనీ ఆఫ్ అస్, లైక్ మెనీ ఆఫ్ యూ, ఐ వాజ్ బోర్న్ ఎల్స్వేర్ బట్ ఐ హావ్ మైగ్రేటెడ్ టు హైదరాబాద్. ఐ కేమ్ హియర్ ఫర్ మై స్కూలింగ్. నేను హై స్కూల్లో ఉన్నప్పుడు ఇక్కడికి వచ్చాను. ఐ వాజ్ హియర్ ఇన్ మై 8th, 9th and 10th. ఐ యూస్ టు గో టు అ స్కూల్ కాల్డ్ సెయింట్ జార్జెస్ గ్రామర్ స్కూల్ ఇన్ అబెట్స్ హైదరాబాద్. నౌ ఐ రిమెంబర్ ఇట్ వెరీ వెరీ వివిడ్లీ. దట్ వాజ్ ద టైమ్ వెన్ ఐ వాజ్ మేబీ 13 or 14. దిస్ వాజ్ 30 years ago. ఐ యూస్ టు రిమెంబర్ వెరీ వెరీ వివిడ్లీ. ఐ స్టిల్ రిమెంబర్ ఇట్. ప్రతి సంవత్సరం హైదరాబాద్లో ఎవ్రీ ఇయర్ వితౌట్ అన్ ఎక్సెప్షన్ వీ యూస్ టు లుక్ ఫార్వర్డ్ యాజ్ చిల్డ్రన్. బికాస్ మీకు తెలుసు, చిన్నపిల్లలకి స్కూల్ గోయింగ్ చిల్డ్రన్కి స్కూల్కి పోవడం ఎవరికి ఇష్టం ఉండదు. ఎప్పుడు హాలిడే వస్తుందని చూస్తూ ఉంటారు. మేము కూడా అట్లాగే చూసేవాళ్ళం. ఖచ్చితంగా ప్రతి సంవత్సరం ఒక వారం రోజులన్నా కర్ఫ్యూ ఉండేది. అది రకరకాల ఇష్యూస్, వాట్ ఎవర్ బి ద ఇష్యూ, 100% కర్ఫ్యూ అయితే ఒక 1 week to 10 days పక్కా ఉండేది. అదే మాదిరిగా అప్పుడున్న పరిస్థితుల్లో ఏదో రకమైన గొడవ వల్ల మొత్తానికి ఒక వారం 10 రోజులు అదనంగా సెలవులు దొరికే పరిస్థితి. బట్ ఐ పిటీ ద చిల్డ్రన్ ఆఫ్ టుడే ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్. అండ్ ఆల్ థ్యాంక్స్ టు ద పోలీస్ మెన్ అండ్ ద ఏబుల్ గవర్నమెంట్, ఐ షుడ్ సే. ఇప్పుడు కర్ఫ్యూ లేదు, గొడవలు లేవు, హైదరాబాద్ చాలా ప్రశాంతంగా, కమ్యూనల్ టెన్షన్లు కానీ ఇంకోటి కానీ లేదు. పిల్లలు మిమ్మల్ని తిట్టుకుంటూ ఉండొచ్చు, కానీ ఐ థింక్ ద ఎంటైర్ స్టేట్ అండ్ ద కంట్రీ మోస్ట్ సర్టన్లీ లుకింగ్ అప్ టు తెలంగాణ ఫర్ ఇట్స్ ఎఫిషియంట్ లా అండ్ ఆర్డర్ మెకానిజం. ఐ కాంప్లిమెంట్ తెలంగాణ పోలీస్. ఐ డిజర్వ్, ఐ ఫీల్ యూ గైస్ డిజర్వ్ అ హ్యూజ్ రౌండ్ ఆఫ్ అప్లాస్. ఎందుకంటే బికాస్ యూ ఆల్సో హ్యావ్ టు రిమెంబర్ ద కాంటెక్స్ట్ ఇన్ విచ్ తెలంగాణ వాజ్ ఫార్మ్డ్. లెట్ అస్ నాట్ ఫర్గెట్ ద కాంటెక్స్ట్ ఇన్ విచ్ తెలంగాణ వాజ్ ఫార్మ్డ్. ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్, లైక్ ఐ సెడ్, యు నో, దెర్ ఈస్ అ లెగసీ ఆఫ్ కమ్యూనల్ టెన్షన్ ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా విచ్ ఇస్ ఆల్వేస్ బీన్ దేర్. నక్సలైట్స్, మావోయిస్ట్, దట్స్ ఆల్సో బీన్ దేర్. అండ్ దెన్ ద కాంటెక్స్ట్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ ఇన్ విచ్ ఇట్ వాస్ ఫార్మ్డ్. తెలంగాణ రాష్ట్రం ఏర్పడ్డప్పుడు ఎన్నో అనుమానాలు, ఎన్నో రకాల భయాలు. తెలంగాణ ఏర్పడితే ఇక్కడ ఏదో జరిగిపోతుంది, ఇక్కడ రీజనల్ టెన్షన్స్ వస్తాయి, ఆంధ్ర తెలంగాణ గొడవలు, ఆంధ్ర రాయలసీమ గొడవలు, లోకల్ తెలంగాణ, నాన్ తెలంగాణ గొడవలు వస్తాయి అని చెప్పేసి అప్పట్లో మీకు గుర్తుండాలి. కొన్ని రిపోర్ట్స్ కూడా, ఐ డోంట్ వాంట్ రిఫర్ టు ద రిపోర్ట్స్, ఈవెన్ సమ్ రిపోర్ట్స్ ఆర్ ప్రొడ్యూస్డ్, ఐ వుడ్ సే దే వర్ ఫ్యాబ్రికేటెడ్ బట్ దట్స్ అ డిఫరెంట్ స్టోరీ. ఇట్స్ ఆల్ వాటర్ అండర్ ద బ్రిడ్జ్ నౌ, డోంట్ వాంట్ గో దేర్. పాయింట్ ఐమ్ ట్రైయింగ్ టు మేక్ ఇస్ ద స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ వాజ్ ఫార్మ్డ్ అమిడ్స్ట్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ అప్రిహెన్షన్స్. వెన్ ద స్టేట్ వాజ్ ఫార్మ్డ్ దే వర్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ డౌట్స్ అబౌట్ ద ఫ్యూచర్, హౌ అన్సర్టన్ ఇట్ ఈస్, హౌ కుడ్ ద స్టేట్ అట్రాక్ట్ ఇండస్ట్రీ, ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్స్. ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ ఇట్ వాస్ వైడ్లీ సెడ్ అండ్ వైడ్లీ ప్రాపగేటెడ్ దట్ ఈవెన్ ద ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ ఇన్వెస్టర్స్ వుడ్ ప్యాక్ దేర్ బ్యాగ్స్ అండ్ లీవ్. దట్ వాస్ ద కైండ్ ఆఫ్ సిట్యువేషన్ బ్యాక్ దెన్. ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ లెట్ మీ ఆల్సో రిమైండ్ ఆల్ ద ఐపీఎస్ ఆఫీసర్స్ హియర్ అండ్ ఆల్సో అదర్ ఆల్ ఇండియా సర్వీస్ ఆఫీసర్స్, మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ యూ హూ డిడ్ నాట్ నో ద గవర్నమెంట్ ఇన్ తెలంగాణ, నాట్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ యూ బట్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ యూ హూ డిడ్ నాట్ నో వాట్ వాస్ టు బి ఎక్స్పెక్టెడ్ హ్యాడ్ గివెన్ ఆప్షన్ ఎల్స్వేర్ బట్ దెన్ ఆల్సో ఇట్ వాస్ రివోక్డ్ అండ్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ రిసైన్డ్ అండ్ సెడ్ ఓకే ఐ వాంట్ కంటిన్యూ ఇన్ తెలంగాణ. పాయింట్ ఐమ్ ట్రైన్ టు మేక్ ఇస్ వాట్ హస్ హ్యాపెండ్ ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ 6, 6.5 years ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ అస్టౌండింగ్, నథింగ్ షార్ట్ ఆఫ్ అస్టౌండింగ్. స్టేబుల్ గవర్నమెంట్, వెన్ ఐ సే స్టేబుల్ ఇట్స్ జస్ట్ నాట్ పొలిటికల్ స్టెబిలిటీ, వీ హ్యావ్ ద నంబర్స్ ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ ఇన్ డెమోక్రసీ, నంబర్స్ డూ మ్యాటర్. అండ్ లుకింగ్ అట్ ద కరెంట్ యునైటెడ్ స్టేట్స్ ఎలక్షన్స్ ఆల్సో యూ వుడ్ రియలైజ్ డెమోక్రసీస్ అక్రాస్ ద వరల్డ్, యునో, ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ కంటిన్యూ టు సమ్ టైమ్స్ వేవర్ అ బిట్, బట్ ఎఫెక్టివ్లీ నంబర్స్ మ్యాటర్ అండ్ నంబర్స్ వర్ హియర్ సిన్స్ 6 years అండర్ ద లీడర్షిప్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ ఆనరబుల్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్. పొలిటికల్ స్టెబిలిటీ ఉంది, కానీ ఎకనామిక్ స్టెబిలిటీ రావాలి అంటే లా అండ్ ఆర్డర్ చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్. శాంతి భద్రతలు సవ్యంగా లేకపోతే ఎంత గొప్ప పాలసీస్ తీసుకొని వచ్చినా ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ రాదు. కానీ థ్యాంక్స్ టు ఎఫెక్టివ్ పోలీసింగ్ అండ్ తెలంగాణ కాప్స్ డిటర్మైన్డ్ ఎఫర్ట్స్ ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ 6 years ఈరోజు తెలంగాణలో చూద్దామంటే మచ్చకు కూడా కమ్యూనల్ టెన్షన్ లేదు. క్రైమ్ హస్ కమ్ డౌన్ వితౌట్ అ క్వశ్చన్. నంబర్స్ స్టాటిస్టిక్స్ ప్రూవ్ దాట్. అండ్ మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్లీ ఇన్ఫ్యాక్ట్ ఇఫ్ యూ ఆస్క్ మీ, ఇన్ని అనుమానాల మధ్యన ఏర్పడ్డ రాష్ట్రంలో ఎక్కడా కూడా ఎలాంటి వివక్ష కానీ, ప్రాంతీయ ద్వేషాలు కానీ, విభేదాలు కానీ లేవు. దీనికి ప్రధాన కారణం గౌరవ ముఖ్యమంత్రి కేసీఆర్ గారి నాయకత్వంలో 2014లోనే తీసుకున్న కొన్ని కీలకమైన నిర్ణయాలే దీనికి కారణం. ఆనాడే పునాడి పడింది అని చెప్పి చెప్పక తప్పదు. ఐ రిమెంబర్ ఐ థింక్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫస్ట్ ఫ్యూ శాంక్షన్స్ దట్ వాస్ గివెన్ బై ద స్టేట్ గవర్నమెంట్ బ్యాక్ ఇన్ 2014 వాజ్ అవర్ 280 crore శాంక్షన్ ఇంప్రూవింగ్ ద పోలీసింగ్ మెషినరీ అండ్ ఎక్విప్మెంట్ అండ్ ద ఎంటైర్ ఫ్లీట్ ఆఫ్ పోలీస్ వెహికల్స్ మొత్తం 280 కోట్ల రూపాయలతో బ్రహ్మాండంగా మొత్తం రాష్ట్ర వ్యాప్తంగా ఉండే అత్యాధునికమైన వాహనాలు ఇంటర్సెప్టర్ లాంటి వాహనాలు కానివ్వండి లేదా అప్పటికి ఉన్న పాత వెహికల్స్ అన్నిటినీ రీప్లేస్ చేస్తూ కొత్త వెహికల్స్ తీసుకొని రావడం కానీ ఇవన్నీ కూడా ద టోన్ వాజ్ సెట్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ద గవర్నమెంట్స్ డిటర్మినేషన్ అండ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ద లీడర్షిప్ రైట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద టాప్ లెడ్ బై అవర్ ఆనరబుల్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ అంతటితో ఆగకుండా ఇంతకుముందే డీజీపీ గారు చెప్పినట్టు గౌరవ ముఖ్యమంత్రి గారు ఒకటే చెప్పారు మనము భారతదేశంలో కాదు ప్రపంచంలో బెస్ట్ ప్రాక్టీసెస్ ఎక్కడ ఉన్నాయి వాటిని మీరు స్టడీ చేయండి వాటిని ఎమ్యులేట్ చేయండి డోంట్ రీ ఇన్వెంట్ ద వీల్ సో దేర్ ఫోర్ అ టీమ్ ఆఫ్ 6 పోలీస్ ఆఫీసర్స్ వాజ్ సెంట్ ఆల్ ద వే టు లండన్ టు స్టడీ ది స్కాట్లాండ్ యార్డ్ ప్రాక్టీసెస్ దే ఆల్సో వెంట్ అండ్ స్టడీడ్ పోలీసింగ్ ఇన్ న్యూయార్క్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ లాస్ ఏంజలస్ దిస్ వాజ్ బ్యాక్ ఇన్ 2015 ఐ థింక్ డీజీపీ గారు వాజ్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద టీమ్ యాజ్ పోలీస్ కమిషనర్ బ్యాక్ దెన్ తర్వాత అప్పటి నుంచి ఆ రోజు నుంచి మీరిచ్చిన రిపోర్ట్కి అనుగుణంగా మీరేమేమైతే రికమెండేషన్స్ చేశారో దానికి అనుగుణంగా ఎన్నో మార్పులు చేర్పులు ఇప్పుడే హోమ్ మినిస్టర్ గారు మహమూద్ అలీ గారు చెప్పారు కొన్ని విషయాలు చెప్పారు ఈరోజు తెలంగాణలో ఒకనాడు 2 పోలీస్ కమిషనరేట్స్ మాత్రమే ఉండేది అట్లాంటిది ఈరోజు మరొక 7 పోలీస్ కమిషనరేట్స్ యాడ్ అయ్యి 9 కమిషనరేట్స్ అయినాయి వాటితో పాటు కొత్తగా ఒక 100 పోలీస్ స్టేషన్స్ కూడా ఏర్పాటు చేసుకున్నాం ఇదే ఐటీ కారిడార్లో విమెన్ సేఫ్టీని దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకొని మహిళా భద్రతను దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకొని డెడికేటెడ్ విమెన్ పోలీస్ స్టేషన్స్ పెట్టుకున్నాం అండ్ వన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ థింగ్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ రిమైండెడ్ ఆఫ్ వన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ డెసిషన్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ రిమైండెడ్ ఆఫ్ అండ్ ఐ మెన్షన్ ఎ న్యూ పోలీస్ స్టేషన్ ఇస్ టీసీఎస్ అనే ఒక కంపెనీ ఆదిబట్లలో ఈస్టర్న్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ హైదరాబాద్లో వాళ్ళు ఒక క్యాంపస్ పెట్టారు అప్పుడు ఆ టీసీఎస్ చైర్మన్ గారు అదేవిధంగా రతన్ టాటా గారు టాటా గ్రూప్ చైర్మన్ గారు ముఖ్యమంత్రి గారిని కలవడానికి వచ్చారు వచ్చినప్పుడు వారు మాట్లాడుతూ సార్ మరి అక్కడ చాలామంది అమ్మాయిలు మహిళలు పనిచేయబోతా ఉన్నారు వారి భద్రత గురించి మేము వరిడిగా ఉన్నామన్నారు ముఖ్యమంత్రి గారు క్షణం కూడా ఆలోచించకుండా వెంటనే ఆదిబట్లలో ఒక పోలీస్ స్టేషన్ శాంక్షన్ చేయడమే కాకుండా వారం రోజుల లోపల దాన్ని ఆపరేషనలైజ్ చేశారన్న మాట కూడా నేను ఈ సందర్భంగా మీకు గుర్తు చేస్తా ఉన్నాను దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫోకస్ దట్ ఈస్ ద డిటర్మినేషన్ అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ ద టెనాసిటీ విత్ విచ్ ఆనరబుల్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ అండ్ దిస్ గవర్నమెంట్ హ్యాస్ వర్క్డ్ ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ 6 ఇయర్స్ అండ్ ఐఎమ్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్లీ ప్రౌడ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ బ్రిలియంట్ ఇంటిగ్రేటెడ్ ఆపరేషన్ సెంటర్ ఐ వాజ్ మైటీ ఇంప్రెస్డ్ వెన్ ఐ వాక్డ్ ఇన్ బ్యాక్ బై టియర్ 3 డేటా సెంటర్ ఇంటిగ్రేటింగ్ ఆల్ లైన్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్స్ బికాస్ యూ నో ద టిపికల్ థింగ్ అబౌట్ గవర్నమెంట్ ఇస్ దే సే గవర్నమెంట్ ఆల్వేస్ వర్క్స్ ఇన్ సైలోస్ ఎవరి పని వాళ్ళు చేసుకుంటూ పోతుంటారు పోలీస్ ఏం చేస్తారో మున్సిపాలిటీ వాళ్ళకి తెలియదు మున్సిపాలిటీ వాడు ఏం చేస్తాడో ఆర్ఎండ్బి వాడికి తెలియదు ఆర్ఎండ్బి వాడు ఏం చేస్తాడో ఎలక్ట్రిసిటీ వాడికి తెలియదు కాబట్టి ఒకరు రోడ్డు వేస్తారు ఇంకొకరు తవ్వుతారు మళ్ళీ తెల్లారు ఇంకొకరు తవ్వుతారు అనేది మన మీద ఉన్న అపప్రదం కానీ ఈరోజు ఈ ఇంటిగ్రేటెడ్ ఆపరేషన్ సెంటర్ వల్ల చాలా విలువైన ప్రజాధనాన్ని కాపాడే ఒక బ్రహ్మాండమైన అవకాశం కూడా మనకు లభిస్తూ ఉంది ఇది ఒక డిపార్ట్మెంట్తో మరొక డిపార్ట్మెంట్ కన్వర్జెన్స్లో పనిచేయడం కలిసికట్టుగా ఎఫర్ట్ పెట్టడం వల్ల అర్బన్ డెవలప్మెంట్ కానీ భవిష్యత్ ట్రాఫిక్ ప్లానింగ్ కానీ అదే రకంగా ఇప్పుడే చెప్పినట్టు కామన్ సిటీ వైజ్ జిఐఎస్ డేటాబేస్ ఏర్పాటు చేసుకోవడం వల్ల చాలా లాభాలు ఉదాహరణకి ఫుట్పాత్ ఎంక్రోచ్మెంట్ కానీ అంటే ఐఎమ్ నాట్ జస్ట్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ లా అండ్ ఆర్డర్ అండ్ ఎఫెక్టివ్ పోలీసింగ్ దిస్ విల్ హెల్ప్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ ఇన్ మల్టిపుల్ ఫెసెట్స్ సో దేర్ఫోర్ మై కాంప్లిమెంట్స్ టు డీజీ గారు బట్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ ద ఫస్ట్ స్టెప్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ what I am extremely upbeat about and what I am extremely proud of from as a government servant as a member of this government is the soon to be coming up I think if Ramakrishna garu if you can put it up I think if the real picture could be put up even that would be even better this towering structure called as a command control center it will be completed in the next 2 months and when it's done it will be one of the best iconic buildings not only in Hyderabad but the entire country and more importantly it will be possibly the most effective state of the art command control center for any police force in the world not just in India so my compliments to in fact DGP garu ipude cheptu unnaru aa paina deck edaithe undo akada జనరల్ పబ్లిక్ కూడా వ్యూయింగ్ కోసం కూడా ఒక గ్యాలరీ ఏర్పాటు చేస్తూ ఉన్నారు ఎవ్రీ డే సో దట్ పీపుల్ కెన్ కమ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ వాట్ గోస్ ఆన్ ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా దిస్ ఇస్ బీంగ్ అగైన్ బిల్ట్ విత్ అబౌట్ 600 crore ఆఫ్ రూపీస్ అండ్ దిస్ వాజ్ ఆల్సో శాంక్షన్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద బ్రెయిన్ చైల్డ్ ఆఫ్ ఆనరబుల్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ ఇట్స్ ఆన్ ద వర్జ్ ఆఫ్ కంప్లీషన్ అండ్ దట్స్ వై ఐ వాజ్ ఆస్కింగ్ రామకృష్ణ ఇఫ్ యూ కెన్ ఫైండ్ అ రియల్ ఇమేజ్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ నియరింగ్ కంప్లీషన్ ఇఫ్ యూ కెన్ ఫైండ్ ఇట్ అండ్ పుట్ ఇట్ అప్ అదర్వైజ్ మేము కూడా గ్రాఫిక్సే చూపెడుతున్నాం అంటారు మళ్ళీ కాబట్టి నిజం పిక్చర్స్ కూడా చూపెట్టండి సో ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఐ కాంప్లిమెంట్ ద ఆనరబుల్ హోమ్ మినిస్టర్ ద ఎంటైర్ తెలంగాణ పోలీస్ ఫోర్స్ ఆన్ లాంచింగ్ దిస్ వండర్ఫుల్ ఇనిషియేటివ్ వాట్ వాజ్ ఈవెన్ మోర్ హార్టనింగ్ వాజ్ రీసెంట్లీ వెన్ అ సర్వే కేమ్ అవుట్ A survey by a third party, which has nothing to do with the government. They have surveyed the entire world, the various cities across the world, and a survey had come out stating Hyderabad today, as a city, has 65% of all closed circuit cameras that are set up in the entire country. Now that's not a small number. Bharat Deshamlo unna mottam CC cameralo 65% meeru Hyderabad lo unnai. And if you look at a count of that, there are government-installed cameras, but most importantly, communities mundukochi. Prajalu swachhandanga mundukochi, memu saitham antu mundukochi. Varu kuda ee effort lo participate chesi. Mari Hyderabad lo prastham 5 lakhala paichulku CC cameras anni kuda manaku unnai. Deeni valla rendu jarugutundi. Okati, deterrence to crime. Crime cheyalante bayapadali mundu. Hyderabad lo crime chesthe 100% dorikipothanu. Ikkada chance ledu nenu raanu ani cheppi అంతర్రాష్ట్ర దొంగలు కానీ ఇంకోటి కానీ ఇంకోటి కానీ వాళ్ళు హైదరాబాద్ అనే ప్రాంతానికి రాకుండా ఎక్కడికో వెళ్ళిపోయే పరిస్థితి రెండవది ఒకవేళ పొరపాటున చేసినా క్రైమ్ కమిట్ చేసినా వెంటనే దొరికిపోతాను అని ఇప్పటికి ఒకటి కాదు రెండు కాదు ఎన్నో దృష్టాంతాలు ఉన్నాయి ఎన్నో ఉదంతాలు ఉన్నాయి ఎన్నో ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఉన్నాయి క్రైమ్ జరిగిన వెను వెంటనే మీరు పేపర్లో చూస్తూ ఉంటారు 4 గంటల్లోనే ఈ క్రైమ్ని ఛేదించిన పోలీసులు అని చెప్పి పేపర్లో వస్తూ ఉంటుంది దట్ ఈస్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఎఫెక్టివ్ సర్వేలెన్స్ మై రిక్వెస్ట్ టు Honorable DGP and Honorable Home Minister, I'm glad that Honorable Chief Minister has given you a mandate. 10 lakhala CC cameras cheyandi. Hyderabad shall be made the safest city. And a mandate mix CM gar icharu. I'm sure with your able team, you will be able to do this in no time. But what was heartening there was, indaka meer chupettina presentation lo, Ramakrishna chupettina presentation lo, naaku baga nachindi entante, he was talking about how when a crime is committed, technology can be used adi ai kavachu ml kavachu inkot kavachu inkot kavachu how technology can be used to guide your police force on the best recommended patrol route ye route lo velthe tondaraga ellipotharu crime spot ki anedi cheppochu annaru dg garu nenu ee madhyane social media lo nenu kodiga active ga untanu ee madhyane oka police video chusanu babji ani mi police abbai oka abbai he actually ran a kilometer and a half guiding an ambulance in the city of Hyderabad through that traffic My request to you is not only for your police vehicles but for ambulances also if you can integrate and tell them which is the route that they can take so that if easy ga tondaraga meer hospital reach ay route edo kanipette paristhunte technology vaadi I think that will be a great help please integrate it with our health department I request you and integrated operation center evaraithe nadutunnaro lnt varu ramkrishna garu please talk to the health department please talk to the local hospitals create a network of hospitals in hyderabad both government and private and any ambulance that is plying on the roads they need to be able to find a route get to that hospital in the nearest possible time and that is the golden hour as they call it that has to be minimized please work with health department on this the last point I would like to make sir before I quit I'm glad I'm delighted that this center is opened it's brilliant and I know it will work very well and it will make Hyderabad safer especially last two things in fact one is విమెన్ సేఫ్టీ గురించి మీరు షీ టీమ్స్ పెట్టారు విమెన్ సేఫ్టీ గురించి మీరు హాకై లాంటి యాప్స్ తెచ్చారు ఇంకా చాలా చేస్తున్నారు ఐమ్ డిలైటెడ్ దట్ యుర్ ఆల్ డూయింగ్ అన్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్లీ గుడ్ జాబ్ అండ్ యూ యాక్చువల్లీ మేడ్ ఆర్ విమెన్ ఇన్ హైదరాబాద్ ఫీల్ సేఫర్ ఐ సెట్ దిస్ బిఫోర్ ఐల్ సే ఇట్ అగైన్ బికాస్ హైదరాబాద్ విమెన్ నీడ్ టు నో దిస్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ అ ఫ్రెండ్ ఆఫ్ మైన్ హ్యాడ్ నెరేటెడ్ దిస్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ టు మీ ఈజ్ అ చైల్డ్హుడ్ ఫ్రెండ్ హీ టోల్డ్ మీ వన్ డే దట్ యు నో ఐ హ్యాడ్ అ వెరీ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ విత్ షీ టీమ్స్ ఐ సెట్ వాట్ వాజ్ ఇట్ His wife went to a supermarket. Oka roju na friend wife supermarket kellaru. Supermarket lo evaro vedincharu ammayini. Ee abbai ledu only vaalla wife ellindi. Some harassment jarigindi. She came back home all annoyed, all irritated. She told him that this is what happened. His first reaction was in fact he wanted to call me and complain, but then he said, "Let me see how the system works." Naaku mantri garu telusu kabatti nenu phone chesthe pan avutunda. లేక నార్మల్గా కూడా పని అవుతుందని చెప్పి ఈ కాల్ ద షీ టీమ్స్ డైరెక్ట్లీ అండ్ ఈ కాల్ మీ అ కపుల్ ఆఫ్ అవర్స్ లేటర్ దెన్ హీ టోల్డ్ మీ ఈ 2 గంటల లోపల నాకు 5 కాల్స్ వచ్చాయి ఎవరైతే హెరాస్మెంట్ చేశారో ఆ స్టోర్ కీపరు స్టోర్లో పనిచేసే ఓ పిల్లోడు వాడిని వెళ్ళారు పట్టుకున్నారు కౌన్సిల్ చేశారు. దే హవ్ డన్ అ థరో జాబ్. మై కాంప్లిమెంట్స్ టు యువర్ తెలంగాణ పోలీస్ ప్రొఫెషనలిజం అని చెప్పి అబ్బాయి నాకు ఫోన్ చేసి మరీ చెప్పారు. సి వెన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్స్ పర్ఫామ్ అండ్ వెన్ దే రైజ్ అబవ్ ఇండివిజువల్ డిస్క్రిషన్ ఆర్ ఇండివిజువల్ యు నో ఎఫర్ట్స్, ఐ థింక్ దట్ ఈస్ ద ట్రూ హాల్ మార్క్ ఆఫ్ గుడ్ గవర్నెన్స్. ఐ డూ బిలీవ్ ఇట్స్ వెరీ మచ్ పాసిబుల్ విత్ యూసేజ్ ఆఫ్ టెక్నాలజీ. మీరు నేను ఇదివరకు కూడా రిక్వెస్ట్ చేశాను విమెన్ సేఫ్టీ కోసం ఇంకా ఏమేం చేయొచ్చు. ఉదాహరణకి మనం డ్రోన్ పోలీసింగ్ అన్నాం. మై రిక్వెస్ట్ ఇస్ టాక్ టు డీజీసీఏ, టాక్ టు ద డైరెక్టర్ జనరల్ ఆఫ్ సివిల్ ఏవియేషన్, టెల్ దెమ్ దట్ యు నో ఇన్ సెలెక్ట్ ఏరియాస్ వీ వుడ్ లైక్ టు యూస్ డ్రోన్స్, పోలీస్ డ్రోన్స్, హ్యావ్ అ బ్లేరింగ్ సైరన్ ఆన్ ద డ్రోన్స్, ఫస్ట్ రెస్పాండర్ ఒక ఎస్ఓఎస్ బటన్ నొక్కంగానే డ్రోన్ షుడ్ గో ద ఫస్ట్ రెస్పాండర్. ఆనరబుల్ హోమ్ మినిస్టర్ సెట్ 5 నిమిషాలు పడుతుంది 100కి డైల్ చేస్తే అని. డ్రోన్ వాడితే 1 మినిట్లో వెళ్ళొచ్చు. 1 మినిట్లో వెళ్ళి కెమెరా ఎంబెడెడ్ ఉండి సైరన్తో వెళ్తే అక్కడ క్రైమ్ ఎక్కడైతే పర్పెట్రేట్ అవుతుందో వాడు వెంటనే పారిపోతాడు, వాడు ఉండడు. తర్వాత సెకండ్ రెస్పాండర్ కింద మీ వాళ్ళు ఫిజికల్గా వెళ్ళొచ్చు. దయచేసి నా విజ్ఞప్తి ఏంటంటే, టెక్నాలజీని వాడుకునే క్రమంలో ఏమైనా అవాంతరాలు ఉంటే కూడా గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియాతో మాట్లాడదాం, డీజీసీఏతో మాట్లాడదాం. ఐ థింక్ ఇట్స్ ఇంపరేటివ్ దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు స్టే ఆన్ ద కటింగ్ ఎడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ టెక్నాలజీ టు ఎన్ష్యూర్ వీ రిమైన్ ప్రొయాక్టివ్ అండ్ నాట్ రియాక్టివ్. ద లాస్ట్ పాయింట్ ఐడ్ లైక్ టు మేక్, క్రైమ్ తగ్గింది అని నేను చెప్పాను, కానీ సైబర్ క్రైమ్ పెరుగుతూ ఉంది. సైబర్ క్రైమ్ పెరుగుతూ ఉంది ఎందుకంటే సైబర్ వరల్డ్ ఆఫర్స్ అనానిమిటీ. అన్ఫార్చునేట్లీ ఇప్పుడు ఎక్కడి నుంచైనా ఇంటర్నెట్లో ఫోన్ చేస్తే నేను దొరకను అనే ధీమా బాగా పెరిగిపోయింది. ఎవరికి పడితే వారికి ఫోన్ చేయొచ్చు, ఏది పడితే అది అనొచ్చు, అమ్మాయిల్ని హెరాస్ చేయొచ్చు, ఇంకోటి చేయొచ్చు అనే ధీమా ఈ సైబర్ వరల్డ్లో పెరిగిపోతూ ఉంది. దీనికి అడ్డుకట్ట వేయాల్సిన అవసరం, ముక్తాడు వేయాల్సిన బాధ్యత కూడా మన మీద ఉంది. లెట్ అస్ ట్రైన్ ఆర్ పోలీస్మెన్ టు బీ సైబర్ వారియర్స్. ఐఎమ్ గ్లాడ్ యూ వెంటర్డ్ ఇన్ టు అ మెమరాండమ్ ఆఫ్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ విత్ ఐటీ డిపార్ట్మెంట్, తెలంగాణ పోలీస్ అండ్ ద సెంటర్ ఫర్ స్టాటిస్టిక్స్ అండ్ సైబర్ సెక్యూరిటీ విచ్ ఇస్ రన్ బై శ్రీరామ్. మై కాంప్లిమెంట్స్ టు యూ సార్. తెలంగాణ పోలీస్ షుడ్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ బి అడిక్వేట్లీ అప్ స్కిల్డ్ అండ్ రీస్కిల్డ్ ఆన్ ద టెక్నాలజీస్ దట్ దీస్ పర్పెట్రేటర్స్ ఆఫ్ సైబర్ క్రైమ్ ఆర్ యూజింగ్, సో దట్ వీ కెన్ ఎఫెక్టివ్లీ థ్వార్ట్ ఆల్ దేర్ ఎఫర్ట్స్ అండ్ టు మేక్ ఆర్ సేఫ్, టు మేక్ ఆర్ సిటీ అండ్ స్టేట్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ సేఫ్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ జనరల్ లా అండ్ ఆర్డర్ బట్ సైబర్ క్రైమ్లో కూడా మన వాళ్ళు కటింగ్ ఎడ్జ్ ఉంటేనే బాగుంటుందనే విషయం మళ్ళీ ఒకసారి మీకు విజ్ఞప్తి చేస్తూ, వన్స్ అగైన్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు కాంప్లిమెంట్ ద ఎంటైర్ తెలంగాణ పోలీస్ ఫోర్స్ ఆన్ యువర్ వండర్ఫుల్ ఎఫర్ట్స్ ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ 6 ఇయర్స్. ఆల్ ద వెరీ బెస్ట్ అండ్ మేక్ ఆర్ స్టేట్ ద ప్రౌడెస్ట్ అండ్ ద సేఫెస్ట్. యా, దిస్ ఇస్ ద రియల్ పిక్చర్. మళ్ళీ మీడియా వాళ్ళకి చెప్పలేదు, ఇది రియల్ పిక్చరు, గ్రాఫిక్ కాదు. మాకు గ్రాఫిక్స్ చూపెట్టి అలవాట్లేదు. థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్. జై హింద్.
Thank you, sir. Those were the most reassuring words. May I invite Sri Sajjanar Garu, IPS Commissioner of Police, Cyberabad, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Good afternoon. On behalf of Telangana State Police, my sincere thanks to our chief guest for the day, Sri K.T. Ramarao Garu, Honorable Minister for IT&C, MIUD, Industries and Commerce, for his gracious presence and inaugurated this world-class public safety integrated operation center and data center on this auspicious day. Sir, your vision for the Telangana state and Hyderabad in designing it to be a world-class destination is always appreciated globally. It's also a moment of pleasure to have our Home Minister Sri Mohammad Ali, Telangana state, for your gracious presence to mark your blessings for this milestone achievement by Telangana Police. Thank you, sir. Also thank Srimati Savita Indra Reddy, Honorable Minister for Education, for joining us and sharing your congratulations and best wishes on this occasion. Also thank Sri Arkepudi Gandhi Garu, Government Whip and MLA Sherlingampalli, MLC Naveen Kumar Garu, Bantu Ramon Garu, Mayor JHMC, Koleti Damodar Garu, Chairman Police Housing Corporations, Senior IAS IPS officers and other government officers for gracing this occasion. Also thank all the police officers from across all commissariats for attending the event today. Also thank MD and engineers of Telangana State Police Housing Corporation for this beautiful infrastructure. Also thank all the IT CEOs for coming over to this event at a short notice and gracing the occasion. Our sincere thanks to L&T team, who were our partners in building this world-class center for us. I thank the Cyberabad police officers for arranging and managing the logistics for this grand inauguration. Also acknowledge the team SCSC for their active support throughout this momentous occasion. Last but not the least, I thank all the media friends, both from the electronic and print media, who have supported us in a tremendous always. I thank everyone for attending this function. Thank you, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us at this inauguration.